أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. In the name of Allah, the compassionate, the most merciful, all praise is due to Allah, and may His peace and blessings be upon our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. To all of our viewers out there, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. May the peace and blessings of Allah be upon all of you, and thank you for joining us again in liberating yourself and lifting the shackles. And inshallah, today we are speaking about a different form of shackle, and that is the shackle of bukhl, or stinginess, or being a miser. Again, if you remember last time, we spoke about the idea of jubn, a person who is a coward. Similarly to cowardness is this idea of being stingy or miser. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said also in a hadith that I believe we have mentioned before, خُلُقَانِ يُحِبُّهُمَ اللَّهِ, that two human qualities that Allah loves, and we said they were as-sakha' wal-shaja'a, and that is bravery and generosity, and two other human qualities that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala despises or dislikes. One of them has to do with al-bukhl wal-jibn, that either being a coward or being miser or being stingy. The Quran speaks highly of those who give and those who share. But then there are those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed with abundance. And instead of taking that abundance and sharing with others, alleviating the suffering of others, removing the pain of others, what do? They withhold back. And they do not give. And they do not share. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala despises such kind of quality, human quality. And remember, generosity is a learned quality. So is miserliness. It is a learned quality as well. But we as Muslims, part of Islam is this idea of always sharing, giving others from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us with. And it goes into the form of zakat, for example. That is the obligation upon a Muslim's wealth. Meaning that if your savings have exceeded a certain amount and you have had this savings for over a year, Islam says that you must, and that is not a recommendation in Islam, it is a must, you must share with others at least 2.5% of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you. And as such, this will be your contribution of eliminating poverty, eliminating need, eliminating the embarrassment that people have to go through socially when they come and they beg of others. Because many people do not deserve that. Nobody deserves to live this way. The sad part is the people who are suffering today are not suffering because there is a lack of wealth amongst people. Oh, there is a lot of wealth. But the idea is that this wealth is not being shared because some people have chosen to withhold from others. And the sad part is that you almost see two extremes. One extreme has abundance, but they are extremely extravagant. And the others have abundance, but they extremely withhold. Where one person spends so much on their own personal pleasure, and the other person withholds from his own pleasure, as well as the want to help others in their time of need or in their time of suffering. Islam does not accept such kind of behavior. Islam does not condone such kind of human quality. You look into the Quran, for example. People in the Quran are asked, and there is this idea of how vividly sometimes Islam presents this day of judgment and the type of debate or argument or talk that takes place in the hellfire or sometimes in heaven. They ask the people of heaven, for example, or the people of hell, I'm sorry, as to why they are in hell. قَالُوا مَا سَلَكَكُمْ فِي سَقَرٍ. What are you doing in the hellfire? And what do they say? قَالُوا لَمْ نَكُمْ مِنَ الْمُصَلِّينَ. They said that we were not of those who used to pray. وَلَمْ نَكُ نُطْعِمُ الْمِسْكِينَ. And we were not of those who chose to feed the poor and the needy. And as such, there is this idea of bukhl, withholding. And bukhl, or stinginess, or miserliness, is different stages. For example, sometimes we are miser because we feel that what we have is so little, and we are afraid that if we give it away, then we are going to be in some terrible situation. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds those who give constantly, أَلَّا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ, that the people who spend in the path of Allah, they shall be afraid not, nor shall they have any grief. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's what we're mostly afraid of. But Allah said, I give you my assurances. That is not the case. For example, in the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ثَلَاثٌ أُقْسِمُ عَلَيْهِنَّ, there are three things that I am willing to swear by Allah, they will take place. And remember, this is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He does not need to swear for anything. But rather, what does he say? He said, I am willing to swear. Just to make sure that people get the idea that what I am about to tell you is so unbelievably true. So what does he say? Or one of the three things he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, مَا نَقَصَ مَالٌ مِّن صَدَقَةٍ, that a wealth of a person does not decrease because of charity that he gives with other people. It does not. Yet people are very afraid when such a thing happens. Or where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would again encourage such kind of behavior, where he said, يَبْنَ آدَمْ أَنْفِقْ أُنْفِقْ عَلَيْكَ, O son of Adam, O child of Adam, daughter of Adam, said, spend on others and I, Allah, will spend on you. Because again, we do not share because we are afraid. We are afraid that if we give what we have, we will be left empty. And that should not be the case. There is, however, another level of miserliness, and that is really sad. And that is, you withhold that which will benefit others, and it will not do you any harm if you give. Can you believe this? You will actually withhold that which does not necessarily harm you if you were to give it away, but it will benefit others so much, yet you choose to do what? Yet you choose to withhold that from other people. And at that point, that becomes very sad. However, in the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam praises this idea of generosity. In the statement, some people argue about the authenticity of the hadith. However, the content of it, the meaning of it, the spirit of it is very much Islamic. And it can be proven via other chains and via other statements that the content of the hadith itself is good. In the hadith, the Prophet ﷺ says, إِنَّ بُدَلَاءَ أُمَّتِي لَا يَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةِ بِكَثِيرِ صَلَاةٍ وَلَا صِيَامٍ وَلَا صَدَقَةٍ, that the majority of my ummah will not be admitted to paradise because of excessive acts of prayers, excessive acts of charity, excessive acts of this or excessive acts of that. But he said, وَلَكِنْ يَدْخُلُونَهَا بِرَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ, however, they will be admitted to paradise by the grace, by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَبِسَخَاوَةِ النَّفْسِ, and by the generosity of their spirit. Islam does not only say that be generous in what you give, it said also the spirit by which you give, that must also be of a noble motive behind it. He said, بِسَخَاوَةِ الْأَنْفُسِ, it has to do with this generosity of spirit. And we're talking here about attitudes by which we spend on others. Also in the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would say, الْيَدُ الْعُلْيَا خَيْرٌ مِنَ الْيَدِ السُّفْلَى, that the upper hand, and some people translate this as the hand that gives, is better than the hand that receives. One of my favorite stories is a story of a young man. He said that one gentleman was driving this very beautiful car. He came and he parked his car. So this young man came and he was just absolutely astonished by the beauty of this car. And he was walking around it, admiring the mirrors, admiring the tires, admiring the paint of the car, admiring the glass, the windows. He was just admiring every aspect of the car, walking around and inspecting it. So the owner of the car came and he looked at it and he said, do you like this car, my son? And he said, yes, sir, I really like it. He said, it's my car. And he said, what, sir? It's a very beautiful car. It's an extremely beautiful car. And the man looked at him and he said, yeah, my brother gave it to me. And this young boy looked at him and he said, I wish that I was like your brother. Most people would say, I wish that I had a brother like you. But this young man said, I wish that I was like your brethren. This idea of, why do I have to be on the receiving end? Why can't I be on the end that actually gives? That hand that actually gives. That upper hand, as the Prophet ﷺ has described. We become stingy, not only with our wealth. Sometimes we become stingy, ask people for directions, and people won't tell you, because their time is very important. Ask people just to speak to you. People don't have the time, and that is very sad. So stinginess does not only have to do with money. You can be stingy. Many times people want, you know, somebody to lend them an ear, just to listen to their problems. You know, in the hadith it said that one time, Abdullah ibn Umar was making i'tikaf, and that is seclusion in the masjid, to be the guest of Allah. In the hadith, the Prophet ﷺ said, whoever makes i'tikaf for one day, Allah is going to remove him from the hellfire, or makes the distance between himself and the hellfire that which is equivalent to 70 years. So he is in the masjid, a man looking very depressed, he walks in there, and Abdullah ibn Umar walks to him. What we would do is that if we see somebody depressed, I want to stay away from that person. Abdullah ibn Umar walks to him and says, what is it? I see you very depressed. And the man says, you know what, I have a debt to pay today, and I need somebody to speak to that man. Abdullah ibn Umar said, would you like me to go with you? And the man said, yes. Abdullah ibn Umar started walking out of the masjid. So somebody said, ibn Umar, remember you are in i'tikaf. Abdullah ibn Umar said, iskut. فإني سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول لأن يمشي أحدكم في حاجة أخيه خير له من أن يعتكف عشر سنين. He said, be quiet, for I have heard the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم say, to walk with your brother, to accomplish or to get something done for them, it is better than staying in the masjid for 10 consecutive years. Please extend that helping hand, not only in the form of money, but give them an attentive ear. Give them a sincere advice. Spend some time with them and make sure that you do not fall in the trap of being a miser, because that limits your potentials. Liberate yourself and lift your shackles. Until then, we say so long. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.